guys, and welcome to another designer handbag review. I'm actually not sure if I can call this bag a designer bag, but I just feel like it's more expensive than your high street branded bags, like a bag from Zara or H&M, but still cheaper than, for example, something from Louis Vuitton or Gucci or Prada or whatever you think of when you think of high fashion. So that's why I'm going to put this in the designer bag review category. And I also think it's important to share different types of bags with you. I mainly use high-end bags simply because this is where I choose to spend my money on. I usually wear high street clothes and wear high-end accessories, but I understand that it's not everyone's cup of tea. Not everyone feels like spending a lot of money on bags, but I think something like a Marc Jacobs bag is a good compromise between high street and high-end because you get the quality of maybe what you would get with something very expensive, but you don't have to break the bank to do so. And I understand for some people, maybe this is also too expensive for just a bag. For me, I'm fine spending this money on a bag, but again, it's up to personal preference. So I just wanted to say that before I go into detail, because I also have a lot of other bag reviews coming up. I went a little crazy recently, but it's also because I sold a lot of bags. So I don't want to say too much more about this. Let's just jump into the video. But also, if you're new to my channel, my name is Vivi. I create fashion and skincare related videos on Wednesdays and Sundays. So if that's something for you, then please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel because it helps a lot to grow and get my videos out there to the algorithm and all that jazz. I'm also trying to reach 1,000 subscribers, so every like and subscription helps a lot with that. The bag we are talking about today is the tote bag from Marc Jacobs. This is the Shopper Tote, and this is the size small. So this bag comes in three sizes. It comes in the mini, the small, and the large. Just for size reference, I'm gonna quickly show you the mini. I have another video coming up of this bag right here, but this is the Shopper Tote Mini. And as you can see, there's quite a size difference between the two of them. You can see this one is the leather one, and this one is just the canvas material. Of course, this comes in mini canvas as well. And then it comes size up. I actually ordered a size large as well by accident. It's because I ordered it from Minto, and on that website they didn't really show the sizes, so I just randomly ordered one, and then I realized that actually was the size large. I didn't want the large because first of all that was too big for me, second of all the large one doesn't come with the shoulder strap, and that's something that was very, very important for me because if I buy a tote, I want it to be very, very comfortable. I want to be able to wear it hands-free, and I also want it to be somewhat like a casual work bag, but maybe if I have to go for a weekend or just travel to, I don't know, Copenhagen, or if I have to take the flight somewhere at one point in my life, or maybe even for the beach, I wanted to have an option for shoulder strap. So that's why it was very important for me that it's easy to carry both by the top handle, but I also have an option for crossbody. These are the differences between the sizes. The mini also comes with the crossbody strap, and I think this tote canvas actually comes in three colors. So it comes in this light beige, then it comes with the darker khaki-ish green, and then it comes in black as well. I really, really like the black. I think there are a lot of opportunities with that one as well. You can wear it in so many ways, and also you will less likely make the black dirty than this one. But I needed something in this beige color, and that's why I went with this. But just so you know, you have three options for colors as well, and three size options. So when it comes to price, I think it's very, very reasonably priced for what it is. As I said again, Marc Jacobs is basically a contemporary designer, so it's not a very, very high-end designer, but it's still more expensive than just your high street. In Danish crowns, this is around 1300 full price. I got it with 20% off, so I think I paid around 1100, but I'm gonna put more prices down in the description box or on the screen and try to link you a few options, maybe with sales even. The bigger size is around 1600 full price, and then the smaller is maybe 1100, so there's not big difference between prices. I think they made it very affordable to everyone, so you don't have to decide the size based on the price, because there's really just like 200 difference between each of the sizes, and if you compare the size of the mini and the large, it's a huge, huge difference. Regarding the look of this bag, you can see the size. I'm gonna show you some clip how it looks on and how it looks on when I'm holding it. But regarding the color, you can see that this is a lighter beige color, and then with this you have the white text, the tote bag, and then light grayish saying Marc Jacobs. With this colorway, this is the least visible, if I can say it that way. With the black, the text is very out there, it's very easy to see. Maybe some people don't like it so much. So if you want a more subtle logo, then maybe this is the way to go. And then for branding, or at least some kind of design detail, you also have something on the back. It says here Marc Jacobs something something. I cannot really read it, but it's just good to note, because then you know you have two options or two ways to wear it. If you don't want too much of this, even though I think this is what makes the whole bag, then you can still just go with this one. It's more, as I said, subtle and less in your face. Another thing I really, really like about this one is that it comes with very little hardware detail, and even that is silver and black. So you can see it comes with these like lobster claws, and they are silver. You have the Marc Jacobs detail right there. There's no branding on the crossbody strap, and it comes in this like nylon type of crossbody strap. And then the zipper, which you also have. You don't always have zippers with tote bags. I think it's a huge, huge plus. It makes it much safer to travel with it. So you can see that one is a black zipper, and it works very, very smooth. One thing to note about the crossbody strap is, yes, it is adjustable, but when you are wearing it with a little bit of weight in it, or even just walk around, this one I experienced when I was walking with it in the city with wearing it crossbody, this one was moving. So basically it just got longer and longer during the day, and suddenly I realized it was down at my knees almost. So there's something to keep in mind, and maybe just take a look at it sometimes. Of course you can always adjust it, but if it gets loose every time, that's something that would bother me, because I like to have my crossbody somewhere a little bit around my hip, because that's my most comfortable way of wearing bags. So I hope this is not going to get looser with time, and even if it does, I hope Marc Jacobs or Minto is open to exchanging this, because I don't feel like buying a new one just because they made something that doesn't work entirely. But that's all the negative I can say about the strap or anything regarding this bag. It is very, very, very spacious. I already put a few things here just to so I can show you how much I can fit in here. Honestly, I don't see myself fully packing this ever, because it can have so many things, and if I packed it fully, I don't think I would be able to carry it. So I'm just gonna show you what are the things that I would realistically go with if I took this out with me. So I'm going to pack this for a very heavy workday, meaning that on a workday where I would have to bring a lot of things. Before I do that, I just quickly want to show you the inside before I fill it up with different things. So unfortunately on this film you cannot see, but actually the inner lining is coated, so if you spill something in it, it's super easy to clean it, which is very, very nice, because with these types of bags I'm planning to pack either coffee or drinks or some kind of food in it with me, and if they spill, it's much easier to clean this than, for example, something with suede or leather in it. And then you have this huge packing department. I saw in someone's video that there is a possibility to put an organizer in it, and the size that fits is the same as the one for the Louis Vuitton Speedy 30, size 30. So I think I'm gonna might order this, although I think it's kind of like structured enough now that I've been using it. I don't think I will need to have an organizer, because you have to remember, when you use an organizer it makes your bag much smaller in some way. So I'm not sure I'm gonna need it for this, but we'll see. So as I said, you have this big, big area, and then you have three small pocket departments. So you have these two basic pockets that you cannot close, and then you have this zipper pocket as well, where you can put things that needs a little bit more security, like your phone or cards or keys or whatever. And then with this one you cannot do it, but with the mini version there's also a branding in here, and that you can use as a card holder, so you can put one card in here. With this one it's not the case, it's just decoration here. So now let's pack the bag. I'm trying to find a way to show you what you can fit in it, but let's just see how it goes. So I'm going to start with the most important, which is my computer. This is a 13 inch MacBook Pro. It's a newer version, so it is smaller than your earlier 13 inch. I'm gonna show you that because I have the old one, but either way it easily fits in here, even with this huge case. You can see how much space you have. If I put it here to the side, you have still the whole bag left. This is my old 13 inch MacBook. You can see how this fits in. I hope you can see with this one that the older MacBook basically reaches almost the two ends of the bag. With the newer MacBook you have more space, but I'm just gonna take out the older one because it's getting heavy. Next up, I have a charger. I have a notebook and a calendar. I'm gonna try to do it in a way where I put the bigger things in the big pocket. Oops. So I have my sunglasses, my perfume in the big one. Then I have my real glasses in here as well. And then the small things I'm gonna put in the little pockets. So I have two lipstick just because I found them here, a mouth spray. These are all going to the small zipper pocket. Tissues, I'm just gonna put them into the little pocket without zipper, just so I can easily catch it. My phone, it's an 8 plus. So this goes to the zipper pocket as well. My AirPods, going to the zipper pocket. And then I will put my key in as well, but I don't wanna pick it up now. So I listed all these things. It is super heavy now, but you can see I still have space. So I have the notebooks there, I have the computer there, I have one pair of sunglasses, my normal glasses there, perfume, and then all the other things in this pocket. And still I could put more things in. I could put maybe a little pack of sandwich or something. I could put a bottle in there. And again, this is not something I would ever go with. This is extremely a lot. I would never carry so many things. I just wanted to show you that you have so much space in this bag. You really can pack it if you're going to the beach or if you're going for a weekend. You can put your basics in, no problem whatsoever. But I'm getting out of breath because it was so heavy to pack. So yes, I think that is basically it about this bag. You can see how much it can fit. I talked about the pricing, what kind of variations you can get it with, the durability. I cannot say too much about. I have one Marc Jacobs bag. I had it for quite some time, actually many years, but I didn't really wear it, so I don't know how well Marc Jacobs bags hold. I think they have a good reputation. At least their leather is really, really good and lasts for a long time. And I believe because this is a canvas, this will also last a long, long time. You can see the sewing is done very, very well, and it's a sturdy canvas material. So I think it can hold a lot. Of course, not if you carry 10, 20 kilos every day in this bag. So that's something to keep in mind. But otherwise, I think you can expect a lot from this bag, and probably you can have it for a few years in your collection if you take care of it. But also remember that this is canvas and it's a beige color, so you likely have to think about color transfer maybe, or just, you know, if you put it down to a dirty spot, just try to clean it right away because it's just gonna get harder and harder with time. Now I'm just gonna quickly show you how it looks on. This is the shortest way to wear it crossbody. And this is the longest one. So unless you're 2 meter high, I don't think you will have to use it in this length. But that was it for today. I hope you liked this video. It was super short, but I just wanted to show you what you can expect when you order this bag. One thing I forgot to mention, that this one came without a dust bag. The mini leather version came with a bag. I don't know if it's because of the seller I got it from, because Minto works the same way as Farfetch, so they send the items from different independent sellers. But the point is, I didn't get any dust bag with it. It's not the most important thing, but it's important to mention sometimes. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and remember to subscribe, and hopefully I see you at my next one. Bye.